the theorems, and also with several examples. Okay, so and then we move on to section 1.2 about right angle trigonometry. We introduced these sides, all right, for triangle, for right triangle, and the definition of these sides and their some cosine function, sine function, and tangent function, the definitions, right? Okay, well, today we're going to continue with this one, all right, with this right triangles. Now, as we said in last class, all right, given this triangle and this angle theta, we call this side, this opposite side, right? So it's, opposite side of theta, of the angle theta, is the side here, and then adjacent side, and then this AC, side AC is hypotenuse, right? It's the hypotenuse. And then given all these ones, we can define the sine, cosine, and tangent function. Sine is the opposite over hypotenuse. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. Tangent is the opposite over adjacent. Okay, so now let's just consider, give you a very simple example here, all right? So let's say this is a 5, and this is a 12, and this is 13. All right, say that this is my theta. Okay, so tell me, what is going to be the value for sine of theta?
Will be 5 over 13.
5 over 13. Why is it 5 over 13?
Because it's opposite side, which would be 5 over the hypotenuse, which is 13.
Yes. All right, by definition, the sine theta, all right, is the opposite side over hypotenuse, right? Given this triangle here, the opposite is 5 and the hypotenuse is 13, so the sine theta is 5 over 13. Perfect. Very good. All right. And then how about cosine of theta? This is what? 12 over 13, right? Okay, very good. And finally, the tangent of, tangent theta is going to be what? 12 over 5, yes? 12 over 5?
5 over 12.
Okay, be careful, right? Tangent theta is the opposite over adjacent. Now, opposite is 5, so this one is wrong, right? You have to be very careful. This should be equals what? 5 over 12. Okay, 5 over 12. Okay? Mm-hmm. Now, if I say this angle is alpha, right? This angle is alpha. Now, if I want to find the sine of alpha, so for the angle alpha, what is the opposite side?
12.
Yeah, that's going to be 12, right? Mm-hmm. 5 became adjacent, right? So now sine of alpha is going to be 12 over 13. Cosine alpha is going to be 5 over 13, and tangent alpha is going to be what? 12 over 5. Mm-hmm. All right, so now by checking all these, right, so you have to be careful, the adjacent side and the opposite side is with respect to a given angle, right? So for this angle, I have a opposite side, I have adjacent side, right? Now, the hypotenuse is always the same, right? The hypotenuse is always the same, so it doesn't matter. In a right triangle, it's always the longest side, right? It's always the longest side, okay? But you have to be careful, the opposite and adjacent sides is corresponding to a given angle. Right? For different angles, there, you know, the opposite side will be different. Okay, so be careful on that. We sometimes want to put the triangle, right, in a unit circle. All right, let's consider this graph. Okay. You know what? Sorry. I drawed something. Let me reopen this one because I drawed something there. Why it's not showing that? Okay, just 1 second, please. Let me have it. Because I drew something before the class. I want to save some time in class time. So let me see. Have it now here. Oh, okay. Anyway, okay. Here it is. Okay. Anyway, let me just put this one. Okay. So a unit circle centered at the origin. Okay. So unit circle. Center is shrinking and the radius is 1, right? Unit circle. So this is a unit circle, okay? And for unit circle, I will have something, say this value is, this angle is theta, all right? So this angle is theta, all right? So, and also I will have for this one, let's say that the coordinate of this point is x and y. So which means what? Here is x, here is y, okay? Here is y. So which means what? This distance, the adjacent, in this case, the adjacent equals what?
Be your
x coordinate, right? Mm-hmm. Equals, just equals x, right? And the, what is going to be the, what is the opposite?
Would that be your y?
Yes, right? Because the side opposite angle theta is this side. This side is corresponding to the y coordinate. So this one equals y. Now, what about the hypotenuse?
Bx of y.
What is the hypotenuse? No.
Sorry.
Would it be your?
Go ahead.
Would it be your x y coordinates?
See, this is going to be the length of this one, right? That's going to be the length. This, but what is the length of the hypotenuse? It is what?
It is the radius.
Yes, it is the radius, right? It's a unit circle. Did you see that? This hypotenuse is just the radius of this unit circle. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So the hypotenuse is a unit circle, so the hypotenuse equals what? Just equals 1, right? Because the radius is 1. Mm-hmm. Does that make sense? Okay, all right. So we have for this one, if we put this one and in our union circle, so we have the adjacent side is x, opposite side is y, and the hypotenuse is 1. Now, based on these ones, so what is the sine of theta? Sine of theta is, by definition, is opposite over hypotenuse, right? Mm-hmm. So this one equals what? The y over what? 1, which equals what? Yes? The sine theta equals 1. And similarly, what is cosine of theta?
It's x over 1.
It's just x, right? X over 1 equals x. Mm-hmm. And then what about tangent theta? Is x over y or y over x?
Y over x.
Y over x. Because of what? It is opposite over the adjacent, right? So it is y over x. Yes? Okay. Mm-hmm. Very good. Okay. All right. So now let's consider two examples. To illustrate how we can use these two figures to find out the sine and the cosine functions. Right? Consider this example. Jared, can you read for us, please?
Given the figure below in a unit circle, find the value of cos, sin, and tan.
Yeah, very good. All right, very good. Thank you. This Greek letter is called theta. Theta. Okay. Cosine theta, sine theta, and tangent theta, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. Very good. Now, could you please go ahead and find out these values? Yes, you got this? I got these values, right? I got these values. Okay, so now from this figure, I know that x equals square root of 2 over 2, y equals square root of 2 over 2, and it's in a unit circle, right? I will have the adjacent side and the opposite side. They are both, they are equal, and they both equal to what? Square root of 2 over 2. And the hypotenuse is 1. So I will, by using the formula in before, right? So sine theta equals y, cosine theta is x, tan theta is y over x. So I just plug in, and I found the cosine is this one, sine is this, and tangent is 1. Does that make sense? OK, very good. Let's consider another example. All right, Natalie, can you read for us, please?
Yes. Given the right triangle below, find the value of cosine theta, sin theta, and tan theta.
Very good. Okay. Now, go ahead and see if you can find all these values. Okay, anybody find this value? Did you find the same with me or something different?
Yeah, different.
Okay, cool. If you got something different, that means you're right. Okay, so, all right. This one should be what? Cosine theta should be what? 24 over 25, right? Okay, mm-hmm. Because what? It is adjacent, be careful, all right? It is 24 over 25, okay? So it's adjacent over hypotenuse, right? And sine theta is opposite seven. Over hypotenuse, 7 over 25. And tangent theta is what?
Opposite over adjacent.
Yeah, 7 over 24, okay. Very good, all right. So that's how we do this, right? It's pretty simple, correct? Okay, it's very simple. All right, so now we have introduced these three trigonometric functions, sine, cosine, and tangent functions. Okay, so we give all those their definitions and several examples about it. And then we're going to introduce some other trigonometric functions. Okay, they are what? They are the reciprocal functions. Reciprocal functions. If we take the reciprocal of sine, cosine, and tangent functions, we obtain the so-called cosecant, secant, and a cotangent functions. All right, so now be careful. The cosecant is 1 over sine. All right, cosecant is 1 over sine, which is what? The hypotenuse over opposite. All right, so this is theta. Opposite, adjacent, and the hypotenuse. Right? So then cosecant theta is 1 over sine. All right, we know that sine is what? Sine is the opposite over hypotenuse, right? Mm-hmm. Opposite over hypotenuse. Then 1 over sine theta, which is the reciprocal of sine, is going to be what? Hypotenuse over opposite. Right? So it's the it is this one, right? So you have to be careful here. Then we have what? Cosecant theta is defined as the reciprocal of sine. So by definition, we know it is the hypotenuse over opposite. Now, what is going to be the value of cosecant theta? I think the hypotenuse is longer than the opposite one, right? In a, mm-hmm. in a right triangle, the hypotenuse is the longest one, right? So you will see that this cosecant theta here for this theta in a triangle, the acute angle in a triangle, the cosine of theta should be what? Greater than what?
Right? Greater than one.
It should be greater than one, right? Okay, mm-hmm. because this hypotenuse over opposite, right? It's greater than one. Okay. Now, then the sine is one over, because cosecant is 1 over sine, and sine is going to be 1 over cosecant. They are reciprocal to each other, right? They're reciprocals. Okay? Another thing is, okay, another thing is what? Cosecant, right? It's cosecant. It's a second, right? Second is 1 over cosine by similar argument. It equals a hypotenuse over adjacent because it's 1 over cosine, right? Now cosine is the adjacent over hypotenuse, then the reciprocal of that is hypotenuse over adjacent. So now because second theta equals 1 over cosine theta is 1 over second theta. They are reciprocal to each other, all right? So, and then finally cotangent theta is 1 over tangent theta is adjacent over opposite, all right? Tangent is opposite over adjacent, cotangent is going to be adjacent over opposite. All right, so we have tangent theta equals 1 over cotangent theta. They are reciprocal functions of sine, cosine, and tangent. Now, you have to be careful, all right? So second is 1 over cosine. Cosecant is 1 over sine. All right, you have to memorize it. Okay. Now, the way I memorize this is, okay, so this initial is C, and this initial is what? S, right? So CS, right? CS. Now, this is S, then this will be C, right? SC. So they are not going to be the same. Cosecant is 1 over sine, right? second is 1 over cosine. Right? It's not 1 over sine, right? Because otherwise they are going to be the same initial, right? So it's going to be a different initial. Okay, so that's one way to memorize this. Now, there are many problems asking for all the six trigonometric functions for a given angle in a triangle. All right? A possible strategy to use is to find the sine, cosine, and tangent of these angles first, right? And then using the reciprocals, right, to find the reciprocal functions, to use these relationships, right? You firstly find the sine, cosine, and tangent, and then using these reciprocal relations to find these reciprocal functions. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. So consider this exam, Mustafa. Can you read for us, please?
Given the right triangle below, find the value of cosine
alpha
of alpha, sine of alpha, and tangent of alpha, cosecant of alpha, secant of alpha, and cotangent of alpha.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Mustafa. That's very good. All right, so let's do this one. Okay, now the strategy is what? You may do that by definition, or you can just do using this one, right? So either way is fine. So let's just do, firstly find the cosine, sine, and tangent, right? Can you find all these ones? What is cosine alpha? Cosine alpha is a 4 over 5 or 3 over 5?
4 over 5.
4 over 5. Okay, for alpha, adjacent is 4, right? Opposite is 3. So This is a 4 over 5. And sine alpha is 3 over 5. And tangent alpha is 3 over 4. Okay, then, all right. What is cosecant alpha? Equals what? 1 over sine or cosine?
Sine.
1 over sine, all right? So you need to choose a different initial, right? It's not cosine, right? It's not a cosine, all right? Because for cosine, they have the same initials, right? So it cannot be cosine here. So it must be what? 1 over sine alpha. So it's 1 over 5 over 3, so 3 over 5, that's going to be 5 over 3, which is what? The hypotenuse over opposite, right? Over opposite. And second alpha equals 1 over cosine of theta, of alpha, so is 5 over 4, right? 5 over 4. And finally, cotangent alpha is going to be 4 over 3. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
All right, very good. Okay. This is basically how we do the problem like this, right? Given the triangle, we can use definition to find the value for cosine, sine, and tangent, and using the reciprocal relationship between them to find the reciprocal functions, cosecant, second, and cotangent. Yes? Okay. Very good. There are several, in trigonometry, there are some special angles. Okay, some special angles. Now, there are usually multiples of what? Multiples of 30 degree, 45 degree, or 60 degree. Okay, so these are considered as special angles, right? Special angles. Later on, we are going to do more about it. But right now, we are going to focus on these two, or these three, okay? So consider theta. If theta equals 30 or pi over 6. Now, be careful. 30 degree is, in degree, is the same as pi over 6 in radian. Okay, in radian, because pi is 180 degree, 180 over 6, that's exactly 30 degree. Okay. Now for this one, all right, if this is a 30 degree, okay? Now if my opposite is S, okay? So what is going to be the hypotenuse? Anybody know about this? If this is 30 degree, this is S, then what is this one? Anybody remember this? Nope. Okay. All right. It's 2S. All right. Remember this. This is going to be 2S. All right. So, and well, if you do not remember, we can prove this. Right. We can just prove this. Okay. Right, so if you add this is 30, if you add identical triangle below, so this is going to be also 30 degree, right? Mm-hmm. So in total, that's what? 60, right? So this 60, this is 60, and this will be also what?
60.
60 degree, right? They are all the same. So. Mm-hmm. All these will be exactly the same, right? So if this is S, then this is also S, right? So this length is going to be 2S, right? So okay. This is 2S, right? This is also 2S, okay? So now this is the property of this red triangle. If the one of the acute angle is 30, then the opposite is S, the hypotenuse is going to be 2S, okay? It's going to be 2S. Then what about the adjacent? Anybody remember that? Okay, so have you heard about the Pythagorean theorem?
I'm sure years ago, many years ago.
This is called a Pythagorean theorem, which means what? The square of this side plus the square of this equal the square of this one.
Oh.
What do you call the name?
Pythagorean theorem. A squared plus B squared equals C squared?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
Okay, so say that this is 30 degree, right? So this is x, then x squared plus s squared equals the square of the hypotenuse, right? So which equals what? 4s squared, right? The square of 2s equals 4s squared. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that means what? If s squared plus s squared minus s squared equals what? 4s squared minus s squared, and minus s squared on both sides. Yes? Yep. So this one canceled out. Now this one equals what? 3s squared. So that means s squared equals what? 3s squared. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Now what is the value for s? X? Take the square root. Mm-hmm. Equals square root of 3, square root of s squared, right? Now for s squared equals what? Square root of 3 times s.
Yes.
Yes? Okay. Mm-hmm. So there that is to say, we know that for this special triangle, the opposite is s, the hypotenuse is 2s, and the adjacent is what?
Square root of 3 square root of 3 times s.
Yeah, square root of 3 times s. Okay. So then we got this one, right? So we got all the sides of this triangle. Okay, then, okay, we can we find the cosine, sine, and these ones? Yes, we can find all those, right? So now let's just, because the reciprocal functions are just the reciprocals, right? So we can just list the sine, cosine, and tangent. For the other three, you can use the reciprocal relation to find them. Okay, so to save time, I'm going to just put the sine, cosine, and tangent here. All right, so what is going to be sine 30 degree?
S over 3 squared times S. Oh, I'm sorry, sine. Over 2S.
Sine, yes. S over 2S. S and S cancel out. Mm-hmm. So it is what?
1 over 2.
1 over 2. Okay. So similarly, cosine 30 degree equals square root of 3S over 2S. This equals square root of 3 over 2. Yeah. And then tangent.
S
30 equals what?
S over 3 squared times S.
Yes, S over square root of 3 times S. Now, simplify this one. This one equals 1 over square root of 3, right? Mm-hmm. But we would prefer to have a rational number on the denominator, right? So this one can be rewritten as 1 times square root of 3 and square root of 3 times square root of 3. Yes? Mm-hmm. Now, this one on the bottom, we see that that's what? On the top is square root of 3. On the bottom, that's what?
That'd be 3.
That'd be 3. Right? Because 2 square root, their multiple is going to be just a 3. So, what do we have for this? All right, we have something very interesting, right? Sine 230 equals 30 degree equals 1/2. Cosine 30 degree is square root of 3 over 2. Tangent 30 degree equals what? Square root of 3 over 3. All right, we got to memorize these ones. All right. Now, similarly, based on the same function, same triangle here, if this is 30 degree, this is going to be 60 degree, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what is going to be sine 60 degree?
Square root of 3s over 20 over 25 or 2s, sorry, 25.
Yes, sorry, square root of 3 times s over 2s, right? So for the angle 60 degree, the opposite is square root of 3s, right? So mm-hmm. S and S cancel out. So this is square root of 3 over 2. Mm-hmm. Yes? Okay. Very good, right? And similarly, we can find cosine 60. Cosine 60 equals what? Equals S over 2s. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
So which is 1/2. And finally, tangent 60. This one equals, tangent 60 equals what? Square root of 3s over s, right? Mm-hmm. Opposite over adjacent. So this one equals just square root of 3. Did you see something interesting here by comparing the 30 degrees and 60 degrees, these values?
The sine for 30 is the equivalent to the cosine of 60 and vice versa on the cosine and sine.
Yes. And also, very interesting, right? This is the sine 30 is 1/2, and it's the same as cosine 60 is also 1/2, right? And the cosine 30 is square root of 3 over 2. And sine 60 is square root of 3 over 2. And there is also something interesting about a tangent, right? The tangent is 1 over square root of 3 over 3, and tangent 60 is square root of 3. They are reciprocal to each other. One is what? S over square root of 3 over 3, square root of 3 over times S, right? So this is by definition. And this one is square root of 3 S over S. So they're reciprocal to each other. Yes? Okay. Mm-hmm. So this is a very, very interesting property. Do you know why we have such a relationship?
Because that has 30 degrees also.
Yes. Because what? Their summation, they're in the same triangle, same right triangle, right? Mm-hmm. They are in the same right triangle, which means what, 30 and 60, their summation is 90 degrees. Okay, so in other words, we say these two are what? Complementary, right? They're complementary. If their summation is 90 degrees. Okay, all right, so this is these are two special ones. Okay, now let's consider the third one, 45 degrees. So 45, that's going to be half of a right triangle. Yes? Mm-hmm. Half of a right triangle. Now, because these two are the same, if this is S, then this is going to be also S. The opposite and adjacent will be the same, right? Because mm-hmm. these two angles are the same. Now, if this is S, this is S, what is the hypotenuse? Hmm? Square root of what? Okay, so again, we are going to use Pythagorean theorem. All right, so a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So here x is the hypotenuse, then x squared equals what? The square of these two sides, right? Mm-hmm. Then which equals what? 2s squared, right? So mm-hmm. therefore x equals what? Square root mm-hmm. of 2s squared, which is square root of 2 times s, right? Square root mm-hmm. of 2 times s. We have found all these three sides, all right? The opposite and adjacent are both s, and the hypotenuse is square root of 2s. Then what is, go ahead.
Is the s with the square root, or is it under it, or is it not under it?
Well, this one here is under the square root.
But now the other one is not?
The other one is not.
Okay.
The other one is not. Okay, so here is the sine 45 degree equals what?
S over 2, square root of 2 over S.
Yeah, so which equals 1 over square root of 2 over 2. But this one can be written as what? 1 times square root of 2 over square root of 2 times square root of 2, right? So on the top is square root of 2, on the bottom is also, it's 2, right? So it's square root of 2 over 2. And similarly, you can find that the cosine is the same value as well, yes? Because cosine 45 is what? Is exactly the same. It's s over square root of 2s, right? So we see that this one equals what? Cosine 45 degree as well, right? Did you see this? Because the adjacent side and the opposite side are the same. Okay, so sine 45 and cosine 45 are the same. So they are all what? They are both square root over 2. And what about the tangent?
It would be S over S.
S over S, which is?
One.
One.
Very good. Okay. Well, this is how we do this, right? We use these special angles, and we're using the right triangle. Then we find out the values of the sine, cosine, and tangent functions. Now, of course, based on these three values, we can find out the other three reciprocal functions, right? So what are the cosecant, the second, cosecant, right? Cosecant, and so on, the other ones. Now, another thing I want to mention is here we are using sine 30 degrees, right? So you can also write as what? Sine pi over 6. right? Sine pi over 6 is also good, all right? Now, pi over 6 is in radians, 30 degrees in degrees. Okay, they're all the same. All right, so that's some special angles, okay? We introduced it here, and also we realized there are some very interesting relationship, right, between 30 and 60, right? The sine of 30 is cosine of 60, and cosine of 30 is sine of 60, and tangent 30 is the reciprocal of tangent 60, all right, so, and so on. All right, so based on those, this relationship, all right, between sine and cosine, as we observed between these two angles, 30 degree and 60 degree. Now, we actually have a very general result, okay? So it is going to be the complementary angles, right? So what do we mean by complementary angles? Now, two angles are complementary angles to each other if they add up to 90 degree or pi over 2 degrees. Okay. So, all right, so now let's just do this one. As you can see, right, so in a right triangle, alpha plus beta equals 90 degree, or what? Pi over 2, right, or pi over 2. So that is what we mean, right? So then in a right triangle, these two acute angles will be complementary angles, right? So alpha plus beta equals pi over 2. So, and then we also have what? Alpha equals 90 degree minus beta, yes? And beta equals 90 degree minus alpha, yeah, because their summation is 90, right? Now, of course, these are in degrees. If they are all measured in radians, we will have alpha plus beta equals pi over 2, right? So alpha equals pi over 2 minus beta, and beta equals pi over 2 minus alpha, right? Minus alpha. So, and then we, if they are complementary, then we have the following relationship, all right? The so-called co-function identities, all right? Identities. Now, which says the following, okay? So, sine theta and pi over 2 minus theta is going to be the complementary complementary angle of theta, right? Mm-hmm. So because this is the other angle, right? So then the sine theta is cosine the complementary. Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
And the cosine theta is sine the complementary. Okay. Similarly, all right, you will have second is cosecant complementary. Cosecant is second complementary. All right. Sorry, this is tangent theta. All right. Tangent is cotangent complementary, and the cotangent is tangent complementary. So this is the so-called the co-function identity, all right? Co-function identity, all right? So what do we mean by co-functions, all right? So for sine, we have cosine, yes?
Mm-hmm.
For second, we have cosecant, yes? For tangent, we have cotangent, yes? So you see that we have three functions here, this here, and they're corresponding co-functions, right? Mm-hmm. And then these identities listed below are what? called a co-function identities because the sine or the function of this value of the angle equals the co-function at what? The complementary angle. All right, if you change that to complementary, that's you change the change it to co-function. Okay, so then you got this. All right, now, and of course, the cosine is going to be changed back to sine, second, cosecond, cosecond, second, tangent, cotangent, and so on, right? So you have all these ones. Mm-hmm. All right, so now let's just move on to the next, and we want to consider an example here. Okay, Natalie, can you read for us, please?
Yeah. If sin t equals 5 over 12, find cosine parentheses pi over 2 minus t.
Very good. All right. So it's awesome. What is cosine this value? What would you say?
Cosine pi over 2 minus t. Sine.
Define complementary angle. Would you convert it to degrees and then just do 90 degrees minus t?
Well, I believe they are in, since here is pi over 2, right? Pi over 2 is already in reading, yes? There's no unit here, correct? So this one is already, pi over 2 is a right angle. It's in radians. It's not in degrees. So what shall we do for this one? We are going to use the co-function identities. Now, for this one, which equation shall we use?
We're going from sine to cosine.
Yeah, I believe we should just use this first one, this identity, right? Sine theta equals cosine pi over 2 minus theta. Now, if you change theta to t, you will have what? Sine t equals cosine pi over 2 minus t. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so which is the same as what? Here, right?
Yes.
By co-function identities. We have the equation, all right, cosine pi over 2 minus t. Equals sine of t, sine t, equals what? 5 over 12. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, very good. Now, this is, of course, using the co-function identity. So you can directly find out this value because this is a sine, the co-function is cosine. Right?
Mm-hmm.
This is a t, the complementary is pi over 2 minus t. So cosine complementary equals sine of t equals this one. All right? Good. Okay, this is basically what we use in the first identity, right? They're equal. So sine equals this, then cosine this equals sine, right? So we just use this identity. We can find out this is 5 over 12. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Questions?
12.
Huh?
What? The answer is cosine 5 over 2 minus t. Is that the answer?
Sorry. This is the answer. Sorry, this is the answer. You know, 5 over 12. Sorry, okay. I should not include this with a box. Now we want to find this value, right? We want to find this value. This value equals sine t equals 5 over 12. Okay. All right. Zhongxu, read first, please.
If cosecant t is 5 over 3, find the second proxy pi over 2 minus t.
Okay, very good. So what is this value then? How do you think? Which identity shall we use? As given what? Given cosecant is, I believe we should use this one, right? Is this a pair, right? Cosecant, right. Second, right? So is this pair, right? So solution by co-function identities. Second pi over 2 minus t equals cosecant. T equals 5 over 3. Yes? 5 over 3. Mm-hmm. Now, what about, let me just give you another one, right? So if second t equals square root of 3, all right, so find cosecant pi over 2 minus t. Now, what is this? Are they the same? Yeah, they're going to be the same, right? Because it's a complementary to t, and you change the cosecant to second, and the complementary is t, right? Second t.
Okay.
Equals what? Equals square root of 3. Yeah, so which is the same. Okay. Now, basically, this is just to use the co-function identities, right? So the second of angle equals the cosecant of this, the complementary, right, angle. So as we know, these two are complementary. Their summation is pi over 2, right? So therefore, second, this angle equals cosecant, the complementary is t, right? So we have that. Now the cosecant, this angle equals the second, the complementary, right? So therefore is square root of 3. Now, this is using what? The radians, right? For instance, if I ask you a question about this one, all right? So for instance, cosecant t equals 5 over 3. Find a second, right? 90 degree minus t. Now, this implies that, all right, this implies that t are in degrees, okay? Because I'm using 90 degrees, right? Okay, so you need to know that. Even though, you know, if it is written power 2, then t and this t is in radians, right? If the here is 90 degrees, then t is measured in degrees, okay? So you need to know that. Then second, 90 minus pi, 90 minus t is going to be the same, right? Equals what? The complementary, the co-function is cosecant, the complementary is t. Yes? So equals 5 over 3. Okay. Now, similarly for this one, right? So if cosecant, okay, 90 degree, right, minus t equals second of t. So it's just different unit. They are the same thing. Okay, they are the same thing. Okay. All right. That's about these ones. All right. So you have to be careful and know how to use these identities to find functions. Okay. Now let's consider the application, the real world application of these triangular functions. Okay, so firstly, given a right triangle, the length of one side and the measure of one acute angle, we can find the remaining sides. All right, so find the unknown sides of the right angle below. Okay, so let's just do this one. Say this is a 30 degree, okay? Now what I know is, I know the length of one side and measure of acute angle in the right triangle. So this is right, all right? I know, all right, what I know is this height, all right, this side is 12 feet. All right, so can you find out the length of the remaining size? So what is the size of the hypotenuse? What is the size of adjacent side given this information? Please go ahead and try to see if you can find this. Okay. Anybody find these ones? Okay. All right. So let's see. All right. So assume that this is A and this is C. All right. Let's say that this adjacent side is A, this side is C, right? So then solution. Using this, because this 30 degree is a very special one, right? So we know sine 30 degree equals what? What is sine 30? I think we found it, right? Sine 30 equals 1/2. Mm-hmm. Yes? Okay, sine 30 equals 1/2. Right? Mm-hmm. And also equals what? Oh, based on the triangle here, right? Based on the right triangle here equals the opposite over hypotenuse, which is what? 12
over
24. 12 over C, right? 12 over C, okay? Now we have an equation like this one. 1/2 equals 12 over C, right? Mm-hmm. So how to find the value for C?
Cross multiply.
Yeah, so you can multiply 2C on both sides, right? So multiplying 2C times 1 over 2, equals 2c times 12 over c. Yes? Okay, now 2 and 2 cancel out. Here c and c cancel out, right? So c equals 2 times 12 equals 24. Good?
I have a question. What did we get 1/2?
Okay, very good. Okay, where do we get 1/2? Here is what we have, right? We derived the sine of 30 equals 1/2. We should memorize this value, right? Sine of 30 is 1/2. Cosine 30 is square root of 3 over 2. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Salim? Okay. And yes. For these ones, we got to memorize it. Sine 45 is square root of 2 over 2, tangent is 1, right? And so on. So we need to memorize these values. That's where we got the value for sine, say sine 30 equals 1/2. Okay? So now based on this value and the definition, we find out that the C equals 24. Now how about A? Right? For A, we can find out using different methods, right? So you can use cosine or tangent. Okay, now let me just use tangent for now. Tangent 30 degree equals what? What is tangent 30?
Square root of 3 over 3.
Yes, square root of 3 over 3, which equals what? 12 over?
12.
12 over 8. Yes, 12 over 8. Right? It's opposite over adjacent. Right? Mm. So we have another equation here, people here. So what do? We can multiply square root of 3 times a on both sides. Okay? So square root of 3a times square root of 3 over 3 equals square root of 3a times 12 square root of 3. 12 over a, sorry. Make sense? Mm-hmm. Now here, square root of 3 times square root of 3, that's a 3. 3 over 3 cancel out. Yes? And here, a and a cancel out. Yes? So which means what? A equals square root of 3 times 12, which equals 12 square root of 3. So we got these values. C is 24, A is 12, square root of 3.
I have a question. Can you, if we know that the triangle is has a 30 and 30 degrees and 90 degrees, we know it's a right triangle, can we just use, we know that C twice the 12, can we just use the Pythagorean theorem on that?
Yes, you can use that as well, all right, because for 30 degree, right, it's a very special one. Then the hypotenuse is twice the opposite. So C is 24, right? So you can directly got that answer. And also you can find out the adjacent. Adjacent is square root of 3 times the opposite, right? So you can got directly these values as well. Yes. But here I want to demonstrate how to use the trigonometric functions to find out the size. Yes? Okay. So basically that's
it. Yeah. In the quiz, do we have to use this or we can just find the answer however we want?
Well, it's better to use this one. All right. It's for the quiz purpose. If we are trying to let you use the trigonometric functions to find the size, then basically we want you to use this fact, right, to find the answers. Now, of course, it's pretty simple, right? I think this is also pretty simple. So based on the definition of sine and its special values, set up the equation, we can find the precise values, right? So, all right. Now let's consider another example here. Let's see, where is Joshua? Joshua, can you read for us, please?
A right triangle has one angle of pi over 6 and a hypotenuse of 20. Find the unknown side and angle of the triangle.
Okay, very good. All right, so let's consider this one. Okay. Find the, okay, hypotenuse of, okay. So here, let me just draw in this way. So pi over 6 and this hypotenuse is 20, right? So find the unknown size of the angle of the triangle. So if this is pi over 6, then what is this about angle? Anybody know about this? So their summation should be, they should be complementary to each other. Yeah, pi over 3. Yes. So the other triangle is what? This is the other triangle is alpha, right? So alpha plus pi over 6 should be equals what? Pi over 2, right? Because they're complementary to each other. So which implies that alpha plus pi over 6 minus pi over 6 equals pi over 2 minus pi over 6. So here cancel out, right? So which implies alpha equals what? Pi over 3. Okay, or you can write in this way, all right? So equals pi over 2 equals 3 pi over 6 minus pi over 6, right? So equals what? 3 pi minus pi over 6, which equals 2 pi over 6, which is pi over 3. Yes? So this value is pi over 3, pi over 3. Now the red triangle is what? Pi over 2, right? Pi over 2. So basically these are all the angles of the triangle. Now, if this is 20, then what is this one? Because this is the pi over 6, pi over 6 is what? It's 30 degrees, right?
Would it be the square root of 3 times 10?
No. Now this one is what? Now this is, you got to be careful. Now the opposite, this is the opposite, right? The opposite is what? Opposite is just a 10.
I just 10. Yeah. 10. Yeah.
Yeah, because the opposite, the sign is 1/2, right? So this is 10, and this is what? 10 square root of 3. Yes? 10 times square root of 3. All right. As we know, all right, in a triangle, if this is S, this is going to be 2S, and the adjacent is going to be what? Square root of 3 times S, right? So when S equals 10, that's going to be 10 square root of 3. This is going to be 20. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Very good. All right, I'm going to skip those details, all right? So, but you can definitely find the values, right? So this is alpha is the power of 2, and since sine, this is A, right, sine, okay. Now, like I said, this one is A, this is B, right? So sine of pi over 6 equals 1/2 equals A over 20. Now this implies that a equals 10, right? A equals 10. Now similarly, as tangent. Now let's use this one, right? Tangent this one. Okay, tangent the pi over 3. Tangent pi over 3 equals what? Square root of 3. Do you remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Tangent to 60 degree, all right, power 3. As we know, it's a square root of, it's a square root of 3, all right? So here is square root of 3. So therefore, we have what? When square root of 3 equals what? B over A, right? So it's B over A. So A is 10, so it's B over 10. So B equals what? 10 square root of 3. So we have that, right? So pretty simple, right? So mm-hmm. You can just use this one to find out. Well, after all this, we have already found the unknown size, A and B. A is 10, B is 10 square root of 3, and also the unknown angles, right? So pi over 6, pi over 3, pi over 2. Now let's consider this example. Arena is not here today. I believe so. All right. Our attendance policy, right? So be careful on attendance. I will contact her and let her know. All right. So let's say, Zhong Xu, can you read for us, please?
And to find the height of the tree, a person walks to a point 30 feet from the base of the tree. She measures an angle of 57 degrees between the line of sight to the top of the tree and the ground as shown in figure 13, find the height of the tree.
Very good. All right, thank you. Let's do this one together. All right, firstly, we want to draw, all right? We want to sketch this one, all right? So you have a tree. All right, this is a tree. Okay, so say that this is the ground. Okay, so a person walks to a point 30 feet from the base of the tree. So say that is somewhere here. Okay, and an angle 57 degree between a line of the side to the top. Mm-hmm. This is a 57 degree, right? 57 degrees. Mm-hmm. Okay, so what we want to find is to find the height, right? The height. The height, mm-hmm. which is the opposite, right? Which is the opposite, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Now, say that the height is h, let h be the height. Right, h should be the height. So then, since this angle is 57 degree, we will have what? Let's say that this distance is what? Walks to a point 30 feet from the base of the tree. So this is 30 feet. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
It's 30 feet. Now, 30 feet is adjacent, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now I think it's better to use what? Use a tangent, right? Use a tangent, and then it's just the height over adjacent, right? So it's automatically got the height, right? So we will get a tangent 57 degree, right? Because this is 57 degrees equals what? Equals the height over what?
30 feet.
Over 30, right? Over 30, because the 30 is the adjacent one, right? So height over 30. So then we can multiply 30 on both sides. Then we will have 30 times tangent 57 degree equals what? 30 times h over 30. Now 30 and 30 cancel out. So this implies that h equals what?
30 times tangent 57 degrees.
Yeah. And then can we use a calculator to find this one? Because we do not, this is not a special function, special angle, right?
It is
what?
It is 46.1959.
1959. Rounded, right? Okay. Feet. Very good. All right, thank you. So you need to know how to use the calculator to find the tangent value, right? So using the calculator, they have the tangent function there. Does that make sense? But you need to know how to do the angle, right? Oh, okay, yeah. Angle is, if you use the 57, and there is the angle, one. Okay, in parentheses, in times 30. Yes, so I can find that as well, all right? So here is using a calculator. Calculator. Oops. All right, to find. You do what? You do firstly, tangent, type tangent, right? And type tangent. And inside this one, you do 57, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then go, what? Second. Mm-hmm. And go to angle, right? Mm-hmm. And choose one, right? Choose select degree, right?
Mm-hmm.
And close the parentheses.
Okay.
and then enter. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Now, for some of us, can you please also try to find, say, tangent 48 degrees. Anybody can find 48 degrees? Go ahead and see if you can find this. What did you get?
Tangent of 48 degrees is 1.1106.
Yes. All right. And similarly, you can find sine and cosine, right? So for instance, sine of, say, 23 degrees. Anybody can find this? There is a sine function as well, right? Anybody got this?
0.3907.
Very good. Right, 3907. Okay, so these are the calculator to use to find the tangent, the sine, cosine, and so on. All right, so we will just put it here now. All right, very good. Now, let's consider another example. Nick, can you read for us, please?
Yes. How long a ladder is needed to reach a wind? A windowsill, 50 uh-huh. feet above the ground, if the ladder rests against the building, making an angle of 5 pi divided by 12 with the ground, round to the nearest feet.
Okay, very good. All right, so let's sketch a graph first. All right, say that here is the windowsill is here, right? So this is 50 feet above the ground, right? The ladder rests against the making angle of this one with the ground. So 5, 12, so less than 1/2, right? Less than 1/2, very close to 1/2 though, right? Very close to 1/2. This angle is 5 pi over 12, right? So this is 50 feet. Now, basically, what we want to do is we want to find the length of this one, right? Say this is C. Okay, so basically, we want to find C, right? So, how to find this? Based on this one, we should use which function, sine, cosine, or tangent?
Sine.
Yeah, I would say sine, right? Sine is involves the opposite and the hypotenuse, right? So mm-hmm. C is the hypotenuse, so use the sine, right? So solution here, okay. Go, we have sine 5 pi over 12 equals what? 50 mm-hmm. over C, right? So this implies C, all right. If you multiply C on both sides and mm-hmm. divide it by, okay, so, all right, so, or you can do, we do not have secant, okay, sine, okay, just a sine in the calculator. All right, so it's okay. So if you multiply C on both sides, C times sine 5 pi over 12 equals C times 50 over C. Now C and C cancel out, right? So which equals 50. Now then we can see what C equals divide by divide sine, right? So equals 50 over sine 5 pi over. So now, can you use a calculator, please?
Mm-hmm.
Anybody got this?
At 51.7638 feet.
51.7638 feet. Now we need to run it to the nearest foot. Mm-hmm. So what is going to be that?
52 feet.
Approximately 52, right? Mm-hmm. Feet. Now for this one, you do not have to do the angle, just input there, right? Just mm-hmm. input the value there for you, because this is measured in radians, right? Mm-hmm. It's measured in radians. There is no unit, all right? It's not like the degree, right? So, which is pretty good. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, very good. All right. We still have 5 minutes, about 5 minutes. All right, let's move on to the next one. So into section 1.3, unit circle, okay? So go over this section. We want to find the trigonometric functions using the unit circle. And two, identify the domain and the range of sine cosine functions. And then the reference angles, and then use reference angles to evaluate trigonometric functions. All right, so let's consider first the unit circle. In a unit circle centered at 0, 0 with radius 1, the length of the intercepted arc is equal to the radian measure of the central angle T. Okay. Let me draw this one here. Okay, I'm going to draw a standard. Okay. So this is G. This angle is G, all right? And the radius is 1. All right, here is X, here is Y, okay? So the length of the arc, say this is S, right? The length of the arc is S equals what? T. Of course, T is measured in radian, right? S equals T, where T is measured in radian. Because what? The arc length equals T times R, where R is what? R equals 1, right? So it equals T. Good. Now, another thing is, well, this point, the coordinate of this point, here is X, here is Y, and this point is XY. All right, this point. So if the point is an endpoint of the unit circle of an arc of length T starting from 1, 0, okay, counterclockwise, which means here is the angle is T here, right? So then what is the, okay, X equals what? Then we have X equal to cosine T, Y equal sine T. Now this is simple because we see cosine of T equals, the adjacent is just X. Yes? Yep. Adjacent is just X, and the hypotenuse is 1, right? Hypotenuse mm-hmm. is a unit circle here. So this equals X. So therefore what? X equals cosine of T, right? Now similarly, sine of T equals what? Y over 1 equals a y, so y equals sine of t. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Now I want to say that this is not just this equation holds not just for acute angles t here. All right, so for any angles, actually, it holds. All right, so mm-hmm. angles can be. Sometimes in the first quadrant, in the first quadrant, X and Y are both positive, right? Mm-hmm. Now, if it goes to the second quadrant, now Y, X, and Y here, right? So X will be what?
Negative.
X will be negative. And Y will be positive, right? So now mm-hmm. this equation also holds, okay? If I go to the third quadrant, x and y became both negative.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and so on. Or, well, it's already time, all right? So we must